Charlie Man, yeah, D Captain. I told ya,
give me this, give me this.
Jesus is somebody I need, it, yeah. Jesus is somebody I need, it, yeah. Jesus is somebody I need, it, yeah. Jesus is somebody I need, it, yeah.
If he carried the problem, I'll be word upon the shoulders. Then I can trust with my life, my life. No mountain too hot he can never climb. No wind too strong that he can never calm down. No disease too hot that he can never heal. The broken spirit, I see him lifting. The broken spirit, I see him lifting. The broken spirit, I see him lifting.
Jesus is somebody I need.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for affording me this opportunity to share the prayer point, to pray together as believers. It's very important that we pray together, because we can see this in the book of Acts, that they were in one accord and they were praying together. They were doing everything together, and there God blessed them. And in Psalms 133 says, "Behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together." And the Bible also says that he bestows a blessings when we meet together, when we pray together, when we seek the Lord together. There is power in unity. There is power in togetherness as we cry out to God, to him. God always hears us when we pray in accordance with him. So, if you saw on the pastor's fellowship, I think that's where I posted the scripture that we are considering this afternoon. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. 2 Chronicles chapter 7. It's the dedication of the house of the Lord. And we are aware that David wanted to build the house for the Lord. And then God spoke to him to say, "No, you are not going to be the one to build the house. It will be your son." And the son Solomon here now is building the temple, and he has called people to come in the assembly in the temple, and he's offering this dedication to the temple, and then he's calling everyone who was in the temple to hearken to these words as he was praying for the temple and dedicating the temple to the Lord. So this is what he said, and I feel we can learn from this, and we can pick it up from here, and then we can apply this same word of God, this same dedication to our lives, and see the power of God in our lives as we seek the Lord and pray together. 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. The Bible says, and I read, the Bible made it clear he was dedicating the temple, and he began by saying this. We can start from verse 11. He says, when Solomon had finished the temple of the Lord and the royal palace, and had succeeded in carrying out all he had in mind to do in the temple of the Lord, and in his own place, palace, the Lord appeared to him at night and said, "I have heard your prayers, and I have chosen this place for myself as a temple for sacrifice." Listen to those words. "I have heard your prayers, and I have chosen this place for myself as a temple for sacrifice." This is what God is saying to Solomon when he appears to him. "When I shut up the heavens so that there is no rain, or command the locusts to devour the land, or send a plague among my people." And 14 says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will heal the land." Amen.
Amen.
My people. And who are these people? We are his people today. Amen. Amen. We are his people. We are his people today. He was saying, if my people, who are these people, we are, sorry, brothers, I'm using my phone. We are his people today. And we are called
to seek his face. We are called to pray. So the prayer number one, the prayer point that I want to bring up from here is humble yourself by admitting your sins. Humble yourself. We should humble ourselves by admitting our sins. That's what it says here. It says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray. Sometimes we can become so proud. Sometimes we can think we know it all. But the Bible tells us in 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, it says, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. And the psalmist again says, well, again, if I had hidden sin in my heart, the Lord would have not heard me. And he says, what you desire is a contrite spirit, a broken heart, you will not deny. So what I'm asking for us this afternoon is to humble ourselves by admitting. You see, the Bible tells us that in the multitude of ways, there is no absence of sin. You see, and if we say we have no sin, the Bible says we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. So it says, if my people who are called by my name will humble. That's the key word, humble. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 2, I think verse 11 says, he humbled himself and came down and took upon himself the nature of a man, and he died on the cross. He humbled himself. He left all the glory. He would have stayed there. Our God would have stayed in heaven, would have sent the angels. But he says he humbled himself and came down and took upon himself the nature of a man, so that you and me today can come into his presence and can pray to him. Number one, humble ourselves. So let's pray that the Lord sometimes would reveal to us or open our eyes to the things that we need to humble ourselves for, or God to put in us, to just put a finger on certain things in our hearts that does not bring glory to him, that can become like a blockage or an hindrance. There are things that can become a blockage to God. God wants to do something, but they like when the oil is passing through the pipe, if there's a small blockage, the oil won't come out fully. But if that blockage is taken away, then the oil will come off and will come to us. So let's pray that the Lord will humble. You know, we cannot say, Lord, humble me. Or that's a very dangerous prayer. That's a very dangerous prayer. To say, Lord, humble me. Wow, it's a very dangerous prayer. So what we have to say, Lord, lead me. Lord, help me. Because when we say like that, God is able to do what we say. Lord, point in me things that are not of you. Lord, take away anything that may stand as an hindrance between you and me. Lord, help me. Humble yourself. We are humbling ourselves before the Lord. We are not asking the Lord to humble us, no. We are saying, Lord, I'm humbling myself. Like what the Bible says in Romans chapter 12, say, submit yourself to the Lord. Offer your bodies as an offering. So we are offering ourselves to say, Lord, if my people who are called by man will humble themselves, we are humbling ourselves. We are not saying, Lord, humble me. No, we are saying, Lord, I want to be humbled. Lord, I'm humbling myself before you. Because God is almighty and he knows. So what we are saying, I'm coming before you, Lord. I'm humbling myself before you. So let's pray on that point, that the Lord will bring us under his subjection. Let's pray that God himself, as we humble ourselves, the Lord will begin to work in our hearts. As we humble ourselves, that the Lord will begin to take away every sin, anything that is not of God. Let's pray in those directions. My God and my Father, I shall bow to you like
We are praying right now.
Lord, where have we lived in my name? I'm asking you, Father God, to watch me and my love and myself. My God and my Father, to stop me all of you.
Father, today we are praying for
you. Father God, in the name of Jesus,
In the name of Jesus, generation of I break it and I break it. Stop us from reaching to where we need to be. Bless my body, my God. Keep me humble. As I'm growing, keep me humble. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Psalm 39:23. The Bible says, "Search me, O Lord, and know my heart, and know my way, my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive ways in me." That's what the psalmist is saying. That search me, O Lord. Know my heart, test me, and know my way, my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way of everlasting. So we have prayed that the Lord.
This is frozen.
Let's seek his face. Let's seek his face. Not any other face but his face. Not any other but his face. Because when we seek him, we'll find him. When we seek him, we'll find him. Let's seek his face right now. Let's seek his face. He says, if my people are called by my name, who humble themselves and pray and seek my face and seek. And seek me. So let's seek his face this evening. Let's seek his face this evening as we continue. Let's seek him. Let's seek him. Let's seek the Lord. The Lord, I want you.
Baba 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 baba
I pray, Father, be in hand of us in the power of name of God. We can't do this, Father. We can't do this.
My dream, my
I pray, Father, for the friend that as we finish, Father, in the name of Jesus.
We are trusting in you in everything, Father. We are trusting and believing that once we are in you, it's you in
I am blessed.
We will praise and bless you. We will bless and honor you forever. But we know who you are. We know who we are. We are in the name of our name.
Amen. I feel strong that in this period of separation, we need to seek his face more than ever. Seek him more than ever. Because when we seek him, everything that we need will be given to us. When we seek him, anything that is holding us forward begin to break. Because when he comes, the Bible says, when he comes in power, when we call on his name, he comes in power. And every chain breaks. Everything, any entrance goes. I feel strongly that as in this period of separation, we need to seek him more than ever. We need to say, Lord, more of you and less of me. Lord, more. I need more of you. I need more of you. I seek only you, nothing else but you. I know we have our needs. We want God to do this. But when we seek him, when we look to him, when we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, just as it is in heaven. Thy kingdom come here on earth. When we seek him, when his kingdom come, we know when his kingdom comes, the healing comes, deliverance comes. He sets us free. He gives us our heart desire. He meets at our point of need. Why? Because the kingdom of God has come. And when it what is in the kingdom, what is in heaven to be done here on earth. And we know in heaven there is no sorrow. We know in heaven there is no sickness. We know in heaven there is no lack. We know in heaven there is full of abundance. And when we come, Holy Spirit and fill us, he will do it. I feel strongly as we separate ourselves, let's call on him even more and more. I don't want to take much of your time. So let's end with this portion of scripture, which says, and it says that if they seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I'll forgive their sins and I will heal their land. Amen. Mm-hmm. Let's pray for the Lord to heal our land. Let's for the Lord to heal our land. There's a lot going on in our land. The land means it's the land is so vast. It means all countries, all world, all over the world. Let's pray that God heal our land, heal our nations, heal our people, heal the cities, heal the states, heal the cities, heal the cities, heal the whole world, heal the country. Heal our land, oh God. We need God to heal our land.
Hallelujah.
We need healing than ever. Yes. This is healing. The Bible says, then I will forgive their sins and heal their land.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's pray in those. God, there are a lot of things that we need God to heal them, heal us, to heal the land for. There's a lot. There's COVID, there's cancer, there's all these names. We say, Lord, heal our land. Yes. Come and heal us. Come and heal our land.
Okay. Yes, Lord.
Oh, Rakata Yamanda Rabus.
In the name of Jesus, we come to you this afternoon, Father. Today, Father God, heal our land, heal our nation, the nation of the UK, Father God, the right of the Father God, right of the Father God, we are ready to sacrifice them. Right of the Father God, we are ready to sacrifice them. Father God,
right of the Father God, the land. Individually, in the powerful name of Jesus. We know you more than ever. We know you have the mighty name of the Lord.
I will hand over to Mama Nkole. Pastor Beata.
Oh, sorry, I was muted. Before I hand over to Reverend, thank you very much, Pastor Boniface, even for sharing with us today and for the prayer points. I think if I can ask for a favor, Pastor Boniface, if you can send the prayer points so that we can circulate them, if that's okay. I know we have prayed, but so we can just that there have been the inboxes coming in asking for the prayer points. So I think it would be helpful if you could send them, and then we'll share them with everybody, because then at least it helps that we can continue standing on those prayer points even as we continue to pray, because we don't just pray here and we forget about it. We continue because this is what carries us through the day. Otherwise, we appreciate, but to be helpful, you could send them, then we'll share them with the people in the group. I didn't want to type them because I wanted you to share them as God has put them upon your heart. So that's why I didn't want to type them on this. So the way you were putting them across, yeah. Then I'll hand over to Reverend. As I hand over to Reverend, I think Evangelist just driving back from Leicester. Because I think they were trying to chase the death certificate. I tried to call him, but every time he was a bit busy, but he just sent a message. So he'll update us when he comes back, because they were waiting for the surgeon to, for the doctor to sign the death certificate so that they can start the process of sending the body to Zambia. So that's what we're just waiting for. So he went to wait in Leicester to say, in case they called and said it was ready, then he's around there just to go there. Then the other thing is, Reverend, when you take over, there's a prayer request to pray for silence, Chihulu, for salvation for his soul, and also for deliverance. So if we can also, if we can pray for that prayer item as well. Yeah, then I think we link up again, we link up tonight at midnight for the prayers for 20 minutes. So just a reminder, unfortunately, I can't see the program. Otherwise, we'll update later who's leading tomorrow.
Amen.
Yeah, unless Reverend Sam, I can't find the program. I'm not a very technical person, but anyway, we'll communicate, yeah. Okay. There is somebody leading tomorrow.
Okay. Thank you so much, woman of God. I think tomorrow, from as far as I remember, we'll give people to give testimonies and
okay.
Word of knowledge and
tomorrow is testimony time.
Oh, he's on the line.
Okay, God bless. Yeah. So tomorrow we're gonna have a testimony time, and also over the course of us praying together, if there was a word of knowledge or wisdom that the Lord was putting, more especially these national words, word for the nation, word for the communities, that we can stand together. So we don't want to leave anything behind. We just want to catch the revelation together, to move together and see what God has in store for us. Amen. Before we pray for silence, for their salvation, there is a hand there. I can see Pastor Innocent Ntali is raising a hand. So I think you want to share a prayer petition for us, with us, or maybe something else.
Yeah, it's a prayer petition. You know, as we are going towards the end of this fasting, we have some issues here. We need a breakthrough, financial breakthrough. We are starting building the church. So we'll be starting the first one the very same month. So at least we need your prayers. If you can pray for us, we are trusting your prayers works wonders. We believe that by the end of the day, we'll see something great with your prayers.
Amen. That's Pastor Innocent Hali, our church back home in Africa, in Zuzu, the northern part of Malawi. He's putting a prayer petition. By the grace of God, God has been so gracious. They are starting to build a church. Remember, we engaged in supporting them with fundraising. Is it 2 years or last year? Last year, them were there. Oh. Yeah, so they acquired the land, a piece of land, which is quite a reasonable piece of land. And they are taking a step of faith. You know, and they need our prayers, they need our financial support, but we'll be communicating these things as we move forward. So we can put prayer petition here. You know, the Bible says, my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray, as we've heard from our man of God here. I want us to pray for the salvation of silence. You know, there's joy in heaven when one person make a decision for God. You know, let us pray for their salvation, that God, wherever they are, God will touch them and they'll receive him with their Lord and Savior. Wherever they need salvation, we want to pray that God will touch it, will touch them. And also want to remember the church back home in Africa, our Warwick Church in Zuzu, that, you know, the financial breakthrough will come along for them. You know, whatever they believe in God for, the destiny helpers will be found. You know, let's continue praying for them, because I believe that as we stand together, God will do a miracle. We don't want you people, when you go to Africa, you'll know where to go. There is a place. You should have a home where you can go and say, well, joyfully, I'm going to my place of worship. Let's just lift these prayer petitions together. And one thing I wanted to say also, these petitions are not a one-off prayer petitions. You know, those who are writing, and just write them down, just remember them, lift them, you know, on a daily basis, you know, where you feel like, you know, you have a day just a thanksgiving for the spiritual breakthrough that's taking place as we're waiting for the physical manifestation of what God has promised. So yeah, let's just together lift our voice before God and pray for this prayer petition. Amen. Mm-hmm. Let's pray. Amen. Mighty God, we stand.
Oh, yes, Lord, we just want to thank you, Lord, come before you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are praying right now, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Ora kata sedere anda baba. Ora masedere anda rabasaya. Oh, we are praying for silence, oh God. Father, we pray for his salvation in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for his salvation, oh Almighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are praying, Jehovah God, that we can pray that he comes to save and acknowledge the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying right now. We pray for his salvation, Almighty God, in the mighty name of Jesus.